everybody has an opinion about the opinion dynamics. Namely, one tries to understand how the interactions between different opinions of different people and how the influence of one person on another gives rise or emerges into either consensus or different opinions or different parties.
Professor Tadmor has made major contribution to the theory of nonlinear partial differential equation and also in numerical simulation of this kind of problems. Nowadays, he's working on collective behavior of population. The question is, why are you interested in this subject?
So the beginning, the starting point is quite interesting. In 2007, my daughter at the time was an undergraduate student in mathematics in Tel Aviv University, and as part of her project, it was a seminar on mathematical biology, and I offered her to look at a paper that just came out by Cooker and Smale, by now a celebrated model for flocking. She then continued to study in Colombia. Today she's working in Google. A long time ago she left already collective dynamics, but here I am still stuck with self-organized collective dynamics of flocking and other models.
Are we talking only on flock of birds and school of fishes, or there is something more than that?
So in fact, collective dynamics is an umbrella for a type of behavior where there is a crowd of so-called agents or social particles where they interact in between, and then from the interaction within, what comes about is some unity where the whole is greater than the sum of the parts. And this applies not just to biology in the examples of flock of birds, it could be how bacteria form cell tissues, it could be how opinions form consensus of different parties. In many aspects, in different scales, you have essentially collective dynamics where you try to understand the overall phenomena, the patterns that emerges from the interaction between the parties involved.
Okay, so I think that the diffusion of opinions even can be a subject too.
Everybody has an opinion about the opinion dynamics. Namely, one tries to understand how the interactions between different opinions of different people and how the influence of one person on another gives rise or emerges into either consensus or different opinions of different parties. A guy by the name Craig Reynolds proposed a paradigm for the rules of engagements, which consist of repulsion and alignment and a cohesion, is a set of rules which translate into the collective dynamics, the collective interactions, and give rise to the emergence of what we see as flocks or some larger patterns. To date, we still do not have an overall mathematical theory for that, but we have a better understanding. And the main feature there is the propagation of information. So the key element in the collective dynamics is to keep talking so that information will propagate throughout the group. Global effect of emergence is important for the global dynamics that involved in this case.
So as an expert on hyperbolic phenomena, do you think that Navier-Stokes equation will be solved in the years to come?
Well, it turns out that when there is a large crowd, the description of this large collective of large crowds has to do with Navier-Stokes-like equation. They are not precise, but the behavior suffers or enjoys the same difficulties that we know in Navier-Stokes. So we know more about one-dimensional behavior, we know less about two-dimensional behavior, but we still do, and we know very little about the three-dimensional, which exactly like in the Navier-Stokes, in the physical terms for the physical particles, there are open questions, and whether or not these questions will be solved in the short time, it's difficult to assess because I do not know in which metric to understand how far are we from the ultimate solution. But what is interesting is I think that the journey itself reveals many mechanisms that will benefit mathematics and science in general, in the sense that we either define the mechanism or we reveal a new mathematical methodologies, and the same applies to the theory of collective dynamics, that we try to understand and to reach the answer for this Clay Prize, understanding Navier-Stokes in three dimensions.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you very much, Professor Tadmor, And I hope you enjoy Valencia and enjoy Spain too.
Thank you very much. This is my first visit in the beautiful city of Valencia. Really one of the most beautiful cities I've seen. Thank you.